Welcome to Food Talk with Sharon. Today I'm going to show you the recipe of meen pollichathu. So meen in Malayalam means fish, and pollichathu is similar to something you use for grilling. So it's actually grilled fish, but it's grilled in banana leaves. So it can be considered as a healthy recipe because here I'm not frying the fish. So we just marinate it and we let it cook inside the banana leaf. So it is not very difficult to make and something which is loved by a lot of people. I think everybody in my family loves this meen pollichathu. So let's quickly check out the recipe. But before we do that, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. And please do click that tiny bell icon too and turn on all notifications. The first step for this recipe is to marinate the fish. So for this preparation, I'm using sear fish. So I've taken sear fish steak slices, which you get ready-made from the fish vendor. But you can use any other fish of your choice as well for this preparation. So for the marination, we need some pepper powder, a little bit of salt, and some turmeric powder. So just mix this first. So just apply the turmeric, pepper and salt mix on both sides of the fish. Now you don't need to marinate it for a long time. And now the next step is to prepare the masala. So that's an onion and tomato based masala that we prepare, in which we would be wrapping the fish and then we would be grilling it. We are using coconut oil for this recipe. Once the oil is hot, add some curry leaves. And into this goes some chopped small onions. In case you don't have small onions, you can use the regular onions as well. So once the onions are translucent, add some crushed ginger, crushed garlic, and some chopped green chilies. Once the ginger and garlic are fragrant, let's add some red chili powder, coriander powder, and some salt. Now into this, let's add the tomatoes. We're using fish tamarind for this. I've soaked this in a little bit of warm water, and this water is what we are going to use. So add the tamarind water as per your taste, depending on the sourness of the tomatoes. And into this goes some pepper powder and chopped coriander leaves. The masala for the fish is done. So let's keep this aside. I've used a Bergner cast iron kadai for making the masala. It uses tomatoes as well as tamarind, but then tamarind is added only at the last and then you don't really cook it for a long time. So as soon as the cooking process is done, because both these are sour ingredients, make sure you remove it and keep it into a bowl. You don't leave it in the kadai, otherwise that could affect the taste of the masala. So I'm actually really liking using these cast iron products, and as they say, the more you use it, the better it becomes. So I'm trying to use it as much as possible, except for these dishes where I'm using tomatoes, tamarind, lemon, etc. I just have to be a little extra careful that I don't leave it in there for a long time and it doesn't require a lot of longer cooking process and time as well. And for grilling the fish, now that's where the interesting part is. So I'm using the Bergner cast iron griddle pan for grilling the fish. So these actually leave a nice grill mark on the fish and the banana leaf. To wrap the fish and grill it, I'm using a banana leaf. So you cut a fairly large portion of the leaf and then you just show it slightly for a couple of seconds on flame overall so that the leaf wilts a little. Otherwise, if you use a fresh leaf, what happens is when you try to fold it, the leaf will break. So once you wilt it, you'll be able to fold and wrap it properly. Now, in case you don't get a banana leaf, then what do you do? So the other option is to use aluminium foil and wrap the fish in that. In which case, you can also bake this. So you need not do it on the stovetop, you can bake it as well. The first step is to put some of the prepared masala on top of the leaf. Just spread it. And next, place your fish on top of this masala. And put some more masala on the top. And once this is done, wrap your leaf around the fish and then use a toothpick and just secure this. The fish is done now. It takes about roughly 7 minutes, 5 to 7 minutes on either side, depending on the thickness of the fish. So because we haven't pre-cooked the fish, you need that time so that the fish is cooked through. And once done, take it off heat, let it rest in that banana leaf for about 5 to 10 minutes before you serve it. And you can always serve it with a side of some onions and lemon wedges. So if you are looking to make that shift to cast iron cookware, don't forget to check out the Bergner India website. And you can always get a 10% off using my coupon code. The details and the link are in the description box below.